Mark, what are you doing?
Oh, I'm just boosting our site's search rankings.
But you're on Twitter.
Well, I know, but I'm tweeting all of our links to Danny Sullivan, Google's search liaison.
And you think that's going to help our SEO?
No, that would be silly.
Well, I'm relieved to hear that you realize that.
Nothing will happen for our rankings until I also like all his recent tweets.
Folks, Mark may not have the right idea about how social media can boost SEO, but believe me, it can. Here's why. So Mark, can social media really help your SEO efforts?
Well, I think it can, Eric, but not in the way many people think.
And what's that? Explain.
Well, I find that many people still believe links in social media posts must be a direct ranking factor. They figure if a posted link is getting great engagement, especially if it's liked or reshared by popular accounts, well, that should influence Google to rank the linked content higher.
But we don't think that's the case. Tell the folks why.
So a primary reason is Google has said repeatedly that they treat social media sites like any other website. So all the major social platforms no-follow their outbound links, so Google passes no authority through them. And even if they wanted to use those links, determining authority and identity on social media is a thorny problem. Websites on domains are relatively fixed and static entities. Social accounts, not so much. Google said long ago that they decided social authority was too ephemeral to use as a search ranking factor, and all our testing has shown that it's unlikely they do.
Okay then, so in what ways can social media help your search campaigns if it's not a direct ranking signal itself?
Well, I'm going to share three ways it can help. Now the first is the most obvious, but paradoxically the hardest to achieve. I'm talking about social promotion as a way of increasing earned link opportunities. The idea here is that through social, more people who own or control websites will see your content, and therefore more of them might end up linking to it from those sites. Now, I'm sure that happens, but probably not to the extent people hope it does.
Yeah, there's a joint Moz and Buzz Simo study that we often cite that showed that there's zero correlation between content that gets a good amount of social shares and content that gets shared links.
For sure. And while that study was not measuring whether any earned links came as a direct result of social sharing, it is sobering to see that even if a post gets shared a lot, there is no guarantee it will get any links. But it's still true that you've got to be in the game to win it. And if you aren't promoting your content, including via social, then you have zero chance of it earning any links. And that leads to my second way that social media can help SEO.
Which is?
Use social to target people more likely to write about and link to your content. Now, this is good old-fashioned PR work, but with the added power of social media for actual relationship building. A large part of what I do every day on social media is building and nurturing relationships, either with writers who write about the topics we write about, or with people who influence them. Now, this pays off not only in being more likely to lead to link opportunities, but also increasing our chances to get legitimate guest post opportunities, columns, interviews, speaking engagements, etc., all of which increase our visibility and, again, the possibility for links.
Those are great, but do you have anything that doesn't necessarily involve, like, link opportunities?
Well, this one is a bit fuzzy, I'll admit it, but I'm remembering that keynote conversation you had with Google's Gary Eish at PubCon Las Vegas last fall.
I remember it well. Gary shared a lot of cool insights.
He sure did. And among them was what he said about how Google might use online mentions of your brand.
Yes. And he said that they did not act like ranking signals, but could help Google discover things your site should be ranking for that it isn't currently doing so.
Right. And among the places he said they might monitor for those mentions was...
social media.
Bingo. Now, I don't think there's any way you can manipulate that, but we don't know, and we don't know to what extent Google actually uses such mentions. But it seems to me to underscore the value of getting people talking about you on social media, positively, of course. That chatter over time could help Google realize the full spectrum of what your brand is about.
Some great starters there, Mark. Folks, you'll want to click the link below to the blog post for this episode, because we've linked to several of Mark's resources that will help you better understand the relationship between search and social media. What's wrong, Mark?
You know, I've been tweeting to Danny Sullivan and liking his post for weeks now, and I don't see any visible effect on our search rankings.
Maybe that's because even though Danny works at Google, he doesn't have any power over our SEO. And even if he did, you're probably annoying him so much, he wouldn't help us anyway.
Well, I suppose you're probably right.
Well, now you look even worse. I wish there was some way I could cheer you up.
Oh, I know. Can I spend the rest of the afternoon watching you work?
Yeah, now you're annoying me.